Normally in video games, we don't expect a whole lot from pistols. However, there are some that have definitely defied expectations, broke the mold, and ended up being even more intimidating than the primary weapons they were supposed to support. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to take a look at 10 of the deadliest pistols in gaming history. And if you guys enjoy these top 10s, make sure to drop a like, make sure to subscribe, and turn on those post notifications so you never miss a video. And now, let's get into the list. Kicking off our list today is the Broken Butterfly in the survival horror classic, Resident Evil 4. Now, weapon management is a big part of RE4 because ammo types are very, very limited, but so are the weapon slots, so you have to figure out the trade-off between what was more ammo and what will do more damage. And if you're looking for some bang for your buck, look no further than the Broken Butterfly. It has it. It's a Magnum revolver that has this awkward handling, but it will deal massive damage if you can land a hit. To put it into perspective, the fully upgraded Broken Butterfly will hit for 25 times more damage than the fully upgraded handgun. I think that is a good way to start this list of the most deadliest weapons. At number 9, Zenith in DE Human Revolution. Now, this action RPG was released all the way back in 2011. It was critically acclaimed, with many calling it one of the best RPGs of its generation. Set in a cyberpunk future, everybody's excited for the new cyberpunk, there is a ton of really cool technology, so it's kind of ironic that one of the best and most versatile guns in the game is a simple handgun. The Zenith will only deal between 12 and 16 damage, but what makes it so deadly is its versatility. It has tons and tons of attachments and modules for you to mess with, allowing you to fine-tune it for pretty much any situation. There is also an upgrade that you can give this gun that it will completely ignore enemy armor, making it almost always a one-shot kill to the head. So if you've never played the game, definitely don't sneeze at the Zenith handgun, because if you're willing to put the time into upgrading it, it's one of the best weapons, hands down, in the game. This month's giveaway is for a brand new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is like the video, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, turn on those notifications, and tweet me why you want to win it with your Twitter handle included. At number 8, the hand cannon in Fortnite. Now, it has seen modifications, changes, nerfs, buffs over the months. It's definitely not at its strongest right now, but it is certainly the most intimidating pistol in the game and also one of the strongest bullet weapons in Battle Royale. In its current form right now, the hand cannon will hit for 78 damage to the body and 156 damage to the head, and it has a bare minimum base damage of 50 to the body and 100 to the head, meaning if you're accurate enough and you have decent eyesight, you can quite literally snipe people with this thing. And the cannon also used to be able to one-shot any wooden player build, but after cries of that being overpowered, it was scaled back. Even still though, it boasts some of the highest structure damage per bullet in the game. So I want to ask you guys a question about the Fortnite hand cannon. Do you think it's good where it's at, or do you think it needs to be reworked some more, up or down? At number 7, Gunblade in Final Fantasy. Okay, this one is kind of cheating, but it's my video, so hear me out. The Gunblade has appeared in a few Final Fantasy games, but it made its debut in Final Fantasy VIII. This is a unique weapon. It's a blend of a handgun and a massive sword. And while it didn't fire projectiles in FF8, later versions of it actually made it a working hybrid of a gun and a sword, working in both melee and ranged combat. There have also been quite a few versions of the Gunblade, even within the individual games. But it is one of the most unique and iconic weapons in gaming history. And since it's technically a handgun, well, that's why we put it on today's list. Next up is the Desert Eagle in CSGO. CSGO is one of those games where it's hard to find something that isn't super deadly, but the Desert Eagle still manages to stand out from the crowd. It is a beefy handgun that you see in a lot of lists like this, and in CSGO, it packs the punch of what you'd expect from a primary weapon. The Deagle will hit for between 40 and 70 damage, depending on where the bullet lands and whether or not the target has any armor, which is respectable, but it's not amazing. But where the Deagle really shines is headshots. Hitting someone in the head with a deagle will deal over 230 damage regardless of the armor they're wearing, making it a one-shot kill and then some. And having a one-shot kill pistol in a game like CSGO, that's extremely valuable, and one-shotting people with the deagle has become one of the ultimate showings of skill and precision in the Counter-Strike community. Cracking into the top five today, let's get some Call of Duty love in here. The B23R in Black Ops 2. This is a fan favorite weapon, first appearing in BO2 and has been since brought back in future Black Ops games, but it was hands down in its best form back in the original. The B23R is a 3-round burst pistol that would hit for a whopping 45 damage up close, which gave it the ability to drop someone with a single pull of the trigger. It would also fire at a juicy 1250 rounds per minute with a very, very short burst delay, which also allowed you to essentially run around and use it as your primary weapon thanks to its great handling, fast fire rate, and its insane close range damage. It is often remembered as one of the best pistols in any Call of Duty game to this day, and people would literally just create their class with no primary and run around with this gun and get 100 kills. It was deadly. Now, number four, let's go back to the hand cannon, Resident Evil 4. Yeah, we have another hand cannon on the list, but as opposed to being modeled after the Desert Eagle, this one is modeled after an old school revolver. The RE4 hand cannon is not available on your first playthrough of the game. It is instead unlocked by finishing a series of challenges in the Mercenaries mode, but once you unlock this beast, you will have access to the strongest weapon in the entire game, not counting the RPG. It boasts a default firepower of 30, then you can upgrade it all the way to 99.9, making it virtually always a one-shot kill. Not only will it almost kill anything in one hit, but it is also the only gun in the game that can pierce armor and helmets, meaning you don't even have to worry about being precise with this gun. The RE4 hand cannon is definitely a pain to obtain and unlock, but once you get it, you're gonna have some fun with it. Next up is the Magnum in Halo Combat Evolved, one of the most infamous weapons of all time. The Halo 1 Magnum was ridiculously overpowered. I'm pretty sure everyone knew it was going to be pretty high on this list. Back when Halo 1 launched, everybody was pretty interested in all the cool weaponry. The plasma rifle, the needler, the sniper rifle, tons of cool weapons on display in the game. However, all that went right out the window when you went over to multiplayer, where the starting pistol was hands down the best gun in the game. The pistol was the weapon everybody had to start with, and it killed in just 3 shots to the head from all ranges. And it was one of the most accurate guns in the entire game. Now, Bungie co-founder Jason Jones revealed in an interview in 2013 that he was actually the one to blame for the pistol's power. According to him, the game was already almost done and it was preparing to ship out, but the pistol still wasn't where they wanted it to be, so the game code was already too set in stone to be reworked. So Jones secretly went in and wrote an additional line of code that gave the pistol a simple damage boost every time it was loaded in. And since he didn't really have time to test out how it worked, we ended up with the famously overpowered pistol that most everybody loved. Now, let's go back to Black Ops 2. There were two overpowered deadly pistols. The other one was the Cap 40, one of the only pistols to ever get banned from competitive Call of Duty. That's right, the other Black Ops 2 sidearm. Now, BO2 went really above and beyond with their pistols. I don't know whose idea it was, but I'm kind of glad they did because it helped make BO2 the fan favorite game it is today. The Cap 40 was a fully automatic handgun with a rather small 15-round mag, but it more than made up for this with its damage and its fire rate. This thing would fire at almost 1,000 rounds per minute and hit for 45 damage up close, making it an extremely powerful gun to have right at your hip at all times. Now, the Cap was so powerful that the Call of Duty League banned it from competitive play, making it one of the only sidearms ever to get banned from Pro COD. But for pubs, it was one of the best guns in the game, and once again, people would just get rid of their primary, set up their class, and run with this as their primary. It was deadly. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. And at number one today, there was never a doubt. The GoldenEye Golden Gun. It was simply impossible for me to make this list and not put it at number one. For those who never got to experience GoldenEye on the N64, the Golden Gun was the second strongest gun in the multiplayer, boasting a one-shot kill at any range in any location on any part of the body. You heard me right. One-shot kill, no questions asked. If the bullet makes contact, the target is dead. The big trade-off was the rate of fire, as this gun would only it only had one bullet in the magazine and also an extremely long reload time. So, You were going to have quite a bit of downtime between each trigger pull, but the damage made up for it. It was the definition of a high-risk, high-reward weapon, and for all the great memories I have with it, as well as its sheer power, for me, it gets the number one spot on today's list. So you guys let me know, what is one deadly pistol in gaming history that did not make this list that was deserving of it? If you guys enjoyed, take a second, drop a like, and I will see you soon. Quick plug, guys, if you made it to the end of the video, if you get anything from G2A.com, make sure to use promo code CHAOS, not to get a discount, but to get some actual cash back on your purchase. Let me know if you guys do. The link is in the description.